Good evening and welcome Grace Fellowship to our candlelight worship service. I want to welcome each and every one of you, family, friends, and visitors. There's nothing greater than to come together on this evening and to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ around the fellowship and the body of believers. So welcome. We're going to have a wonderful evening tonight. We have music, we have a time of communion, a little meditation in the Word of God, and then we'll close with the candlelight service. Make sure you have your Well, if you don't, raise your hand and an usher will get one to you. Let's open with a word of prayer tonight. Father, we come before you tonight humbly, and we bask in your presence in the fellowship, and we say thank you. Thank you for answering the promise that you gave us in Genesis, that a seed would come from a woman to redeem mankind. What an amazing gift. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. And tonight we come together and we celebrate the birth of Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God. Overwhelm us with the presence of the Holy Spirit tonight. Calm our hearts. We pray for a healing for those who are sick. We pray for miracles for those individuals. And Father, we pray for peace. There's many people that tonight is not a night of peace. Something happened on Christmas or something happened during this time of year. So let the overwhelming presence of the Holy Spirit fill us, calm us, excite us, and overjoy us as we worship you, Jesus. And we thank you for the greatest gift known to mankind. In Jesus' precious name we pray, and all of God's children said, Amen. Let's stand.
Present.
Seated. Tonight we have an opportunity to share the meal that the Savior Jesus Christ instituted on the night in which he was betrayed. He came together with the disciples and they celebrated what we now call communion. If you're in a relationship with Jesus Christ, we invite you to come to the table. Now, what does that mean? What does that look like? It means that you have confessed to believe in Jesus as the Christ, as the Son of the living God. You believe that everything he has done, everything he stands for, that he was the Son, he was conceived by a virgin, by the Holy Spirit, he birthed into this world, he lived a life, a sinless life, died on a cross, 3 days later, he rose back. That's our Jesus. Okay, I want to pray. Maybe I, nope, it's where I stand. All right. I just want to be with you all anyway. We've ran into that before. It is where I stand. If you believe what I just talked about, that this is Jesus the Christ, then he says, come to the table, and when you do that, he says, I want you to remember what I did for you. That's why we commune. And as you hold the body of your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in your hand, and you ingest the body and the blood, and he says, remember this process, that I died for you, I took away your sins of the world, you have been made righteous. You've been moved from I, a poor, miserable sinner, into the righteousness, 2 Corinthians 5:21. He who knew no sin became sin so that you could become righteous. That's our Jesus. And if that's you tonight, come to the table. Here at Grace Fellowship, we commune by intinction. We'll have the elements up here. You come up, you pick up the bread, dip it into the wine, and we'll just flow right on through whenever you feel so moved. So let us pray. Father, you gave us this meal on the night in which you were betrayed. You broke the bread, you gave it to the disciples, and you said, eat of it, all of you. For this is my body, which is given for you. And after you had the meal, after the supper time, you took the cup and you drank it, and you looked at the disciples and you said, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. The new covenant. The sinless sacrifice that didn't put the sins of mankind onto a credit card any longer, but you took away the sin of the world. And you handed it to the disciples and you said, drink of it, all of you. Do this in remembrance of me. Father, we come tonight saying thank you. We come tonight knowing that in the meal we can be healed, we can be restored, we find comfort, peace, tears of joy, all the above, saying thank you, Jesus, for what you've done for us. Let us pray the prayer that our Father taught us to pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Come, the table's ready. Thank you. Thank you. Let us pray. Father, there's nothing greater than to be in your presence, and we ask that through the power of the Holy Spirit now that you overwhelm us. You overwhelm us in such a way that we cannot help but confess to believe that Jesus Christ, you are Lord. We pray for the hearts who are watching tonight or are here that maybe have always questioned, that through your presence, let us just be calmed, restore, and reveal. In Jesus' precious name, amen. And everybody said, amen. It feels good to be in the house of the believers, doesn't it? Feels good to come together and worship and to celebrate the birth of Jesus. So I ask you tonight, have you ever been stunned? Have you ever had an event in life that just stunned you? Sorry. I got to take this. Sorry. Hello? Oh. I'm in the middle of a worship service. He's persistent. Maybe I should answer it. There we go. Yeah, but I'm in the middle of church. Oh. All right. That was Jesus. He called to let us know that he wants to come to your house tonight. He wants to come to your house. Isn't that kind of funny? Because this is the night where we say, Santa Claus is coming. But what if tonight we actually, this was real, and Jesus is coming to your house? What would you do? I'm a little concerned because do I have to put any of this stuff away? Do I need to put my Bud cans away? I came into church tonight with a brown bag, and some people looked at me. Would I have to put my whiskey away? I mean, Jesus is coming. Would he be okay with this? I don't know. I'm going to put it away anyway. What about my Playboy magazines? My pornography magazine? Would Jesus be okay? I'm going to put it away anyway. I don't think I want that out. I got a habit here of Lucky Strikes with filters, but I don't know. Smoking isn't bad, is it? I don't know. I think I'll put those away too. Don't know if I want him to be. What about my pot pipe? You know, get high once in a while. My meth stuff and my drugs. I mean, is Jesus okay with? I mean, has Jesus ever come to your house? I'm going to put that away too. Maybe I shouldn't have him see. Oh, I need to get the Bible out. Where is it? Do you know where your Bible is? I don't even know where my Bible is. You got one in a pew somewhere? You got one there? Yeah, give me that one there. Okay, found a Bible. So if Jesus is coming to my house, I want to make sure the activities that I do, I want to make sure the Bible is out. This has got to look nice. I've never had Jesus in my presence before. Got the Bible out. But he also said it's going to be a couple days. Am I going to take him to my friends? Would Jesus be okay with your friends? Would Jesus be okay with the people you hang out with? Would Jesus be okay with where you go? Where do you go? Do you go to the local pub? Where do you hang out? Would he be okay with what he sees in your house? Would he be okay with the people you're with? Would he be okay where you go? Would you be willing to let him see your movie list on your cable? Would you change the movies you watch? What about the music you play, the radio? Would you change the radio station? Would you be okay tonight if Jesus came to your house? You see, I think sometimes we celebrate this fictitious, mystical guy in a red suit, and we say, if you're nice, he's coming. You can bribe kids into being nice with this guy. But what if we taught our families that this is about Jesus coming to our house? That's a different concept, isn't it? What if we actually did what we believe? Would he be okay with what we do, what we say? Would he be okay with what I wear? I've never had Jesus in my house, you say. You might find out differently tonight. What if this actually happened? And I want to challenge you tonight. It's Christmas Eve. Yes, we silent night, joy to the world, all the above. We get excited. It's all good. But do you realize what this evening is about? Emmanuel, God with us, the Son of God, literally breaks out of heaven and steps into the dressing room of mankind and put on clothes, human flesh, and became one of us. And he does come into our presence. He does come into our home. And we think maybe once in a while we just, you know, go to church. Jesus hangs out in church. Pastor, he's cool. He hangs out with Jesus. When I need to pray, I call the preacher because he's over there. But have you ever thought he's with you? That's the reason we do this tonight. We've looked at Zechariah and Elizabeth. We've looked at Joseph. We've looked at Mary. And tonight we're going to look at these shepherds. Common people. Just like you and me. Let's look at the story. Luke 2, 8 through 20. This is a story that you've heard since you're old enough to comprehend. You read it every year at Christmas. We're going to look at it just a little bit different tonight. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in their fields keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them. That's crazy stuff right there. And we just read over that. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, singular, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. I don't know about you, but when an angel of the Lord appears, I would be afraid. Right? I mean, let's just get real. This is not normal stuff. Let's say there's an angel standing in your living room, and you know it. You would be filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you," notice there it's singular. That's why I can talk to you personally tonight. "For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." And this will be, wait a minute, what? You're just doing your thing, you're teaching school, you're being a good mom, you're being a good husband, you're going to work, and an angel appears and says, there's going to be a Savior born. And he's coming to you. He's coming to your house. "This will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God. Zechariah is visited by one angel. Joseph is visited by one angel. Mary is visited by one angel. This is the only time in the story that we have a multitude speaking to a multitude of people. "Now the sky opened up, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from there into heaven, just stop for a minute. First you got one angel, said there's a Savior going to be born. Now the sky lights up and it's full of angels, and it tells you the story, and woof, there they go into heaven. I don't know about you, I think I'd be on the ground at this point. "Glory to God in the highest, and on peace among those with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem, see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." They went with haste. They found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart, and the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they heard and seen as it had been told to them. This message of God being born into mankind is a message for real people. real people like you and me living real life. Just going through life, teaching school, fixing wash machines, being a mechanic, being a pastor, being a father, going through life, being a carpenter, being whoever you are, just trudging along, going through life, and this message is for real people living real life. God broke into mankind to talk to you. He broke into mankind to have one-on-one time with you. That's our God. Real people living real life in the same region they were shepherds, the lowliest of people, the common Joes. And God delivers the message to them. The Christmas message was not for perfect people, but it was for real people. And the first thing I want you to understand tonight, that when you're filled with fear in the presence of an angel, that's real. Because the reality is, when we're filled with fear from an angel in our presence, this is what happens. I shouldn't be here. I should not be in the presence of God. When you read Isaiah and the angel appears to him and he says, "Woe to me, I do not want to be in your presence because I'm no good, you're holy, I'm doomed." And that's the reality, that when you come into the presence of God, you realize it's over. I can't be here. This is God. Get me out of here. And fear came upon them. The fear is legit. The fear is real. We're unable to stand in the presence of God. Hebrews 12:29, he's a consuming fire. Revelation 6:17, for the great day of his wrath comes, and who shall be able to stand? The fear in the presence of God when you're not saved will scare you. And it's supposed to. But on the other side of that, fear in the presence of God can be diminished because there's joy. When we confess to believe and an angel appears, we're saying, "Hallelujah! God is here." When Jesus calls and shows up and I'm trying to clean my house because I'm afraid, I'm not saved. But when Jesus calls and says, "I'm going to show up and my house is a mess," I do, you do, we do things we shouldn't do. But Jesus comes in and shows up anyway. And if I have joy of the Lord in my heart and I have the salvation and the power of the Holy Spirit, come on in, Jesus. I got some stuff going on that I shouldn't be doing, but you're welcome in my house. The message is for real people living real lives. The second one is God's message demands a decision. God's message for the world demands a decision. Now just think this through for a minute. The angel shows up, proclaims the good news. Do you believe it? Do you believe it? A lot of people come to church on Christmas Eve because grandma and grandpa did, and mom and dad go, and the neighbor goes, and everybody else goes, and I guess I should probably go too. We'll see what the preacher has to say tonight. Why are you here? It demands a decision. God opens that door and he says, "Here's my boy." And he told the shepherds and they made a decision to go. And I'm assuming, I've worked with enough people in my whole life, let's say there was 30 shepherds out there, they didn't get 100% buy-in. You ever been in a meeting where you got to have a unanimous decision and there's 30 of you? You might be there for 2 years. You just don't get 100% buy-in. Now, I'm assuming some of these guys didn't go. Maybe they all did. I don't know. I can't wait to get to heaven and to talk to these guys. There's so many people in the Bible I can't wait to talk to in heaven. You know, what was it like to watch the heavens open up and all the angels sing to you? What was it like to be, and you know what they're going to do? They're going to look at us and say, "What was it like to be filled with the Holy Spirit? What was it like to live with the presence of God?" It demands a decision of you tonight. God called you on the phone. God's knocking you on the heart. God's in your presence. You're in his presence right now. And he says, "Would you go? Would you go?" So let's change that. Would you go or have you gone? Have you received him? Have you accepted the fact that this thing is real? This isn't about flying reindeers, red noses, Comet and Cupid. What if Jesus showed up tonight? Would you welcome him? And would you go? The message demands a decision. And every time we hear the good news, we're called to the plate, we're called to the carpet. Have you received that good news? This is the most wonderful time of year for those who have received the birth of Jesus. And lastly, God's message will change your life forever. It'll change your life forever. And another thing I can't wait to ask these guys when we get to heaven, you know, they're shepherds. You know, shepherds didn't get to sleep at night. They slept during the day. They had to watch over the sheep because that's when the wolves and the coyotes and the critters would come in the nighttime. And now they've just been overwhelmed with the good news. Do you think they went back and said, well, I'll just keep on being a shepherd? I don't think so. I think they went to the sheep owners and said, you know what? The heavens just busted open last night. God delivered the child of his to the earth for salvation. You take care of your own sheep. And the reason I say that is because they went away glorifying and praising God. They were so moved, they were so touched, they ran home, they threw their shepherd's staff, and they said, we're going to praise God till the end of the earth because we've been touched. And demands a decision. They made a decision, they went, and their lives were changed forever. If Jesus showed up at your house tonight, would you be praising him and thanking him? And would you thank him for the decision you made? And would you be praising him? Or would you be worried about the lights on your tree? That doesn't have anything to do with him. Isn't that interesting? I'm not beating up Christmas. I'm just being reality tonight. He stepped into mankind. It demands a decision and it changes our lives forever. I don't know about you, but I get excited about that. I don't need presents. I don't need trees. I don't need rotating lights around my living room window. I don't need any of the above. All I need to know is that God did come to my house. He came into me and came into me personally, fills me with his presence. And guess what? I've got addictions. I've got problems. I got smoking habits. I've got pornography. I smoke. I do a little pot. I do whatever is going on in my life. And he still comes. All of you can relate to this table. And he still comes. This didn't stop his birth. God still gave him. God said, this is my boy. And he came right into our mess. And he comes right into your home, doing whatever you're doing. And he says, I still love you. I still died for you. I still did everything for you. Emmanuel, God with us. He still did it regardless of the habits and the problems. That's the beauty of our God. And that's the beauty we come together and we celebrate Emmanuel, God with us. While we were in a mess. And you know what? You understand. You hear the truth. Everybody gets to belong. You hear the truth. Eventually, you believe right. And eventually, you behave right. He says, don't take a bath before you take a bath. In other words, don't get cleaned up before I come. I'm going to come and accept you just the way you are. That's our God. That's the reason we come to church on Christmas Eve and hold candles and hope nobody's hair burns off. We do all these crazy things, but that's the reason we celebrate it. I've always worried about that, and I just said it. So we always pray that nobody's hair goes woof. It's legitimate, I think. Greatest history, the history's greatest news. History's greatest news. I don't care who you are, all of mankind has to deal with the birth of Jesus Christ. Every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, whether you believe it or not, that's who he is. The Savior was born, he was named Jesus the Christ. And he's stepping into your house tonight. Do you receive him? And let him change your life. And go and tell the world, praise in God. Glory to God in the highest. Thank you, Jesus. Merry Christmas to all of you. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that you're a God that thinks so much of us, you just freely give yourself to us. You freely give without any strings attached, and all you ask is that we receive. So I pray for the hearts that are here tonight that have never received. And maybe tonight, through the presence of the Holy Spirit, it's the first time that this celebration of your birth was a reality. And they say, thank you, Jesus, for coming to me. Thank you for accepting me. There's no condemnation for those who are in Christ. Jesus came to save the world, not to condemn the world. So as we come around that manger tonight, we take a glimpse into the life of Jesus. We thank you for it. I thank you for every person here. I pray for every person that we find such a comfort and a peace and a hope from knowing you, Jesus. No matter what the situation is, you're still there. Father, your word tells us that you came to bring peace on earth. For a lot of people who do not know you, there is no peace. There's peace for those whom you are well pleased with, for those who have received you. And if you're here tonight and there is no peace in your heart and you have been wondering and questioning and who is this Jesus, let him penetrate your heart and let him change and rearrange and to see him for who he is the first time. Thank you for coming into our house tonight, Jesus. Bless the fellowship. In your name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. All right.
Please stand and join us.
Baby boy who's come to earth to bring us joy, and I just want to sing this song to you. It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath I'm singing to see this baby wrapped. wrapped in light. A host of angels led them on to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in the manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, alleluia. 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 The star shone bright up in the east to Bethlehem. You were their frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you and cried out, alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Time the ushers will come forward and light our candles. Thank you. Let's stand. Of our Lord tonight. God will bless you. God will keep you. He makes his face shine on you and he's gracious to you. Turns his face towards you and he grants you his peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go tonight praising and glorifying God in the highest. Ginger and I want to say thank you and Merry Christmas to each and every one of you. Amen.